the world is changing. And if the world is changing, politics in its high signifying community interest service should change too. The famous Prussian strategic theorist Clausewitz taught that war is a continuation of politics using other means. I believe that peace also may be a result of the politics led with other kind of means. One of these means is cultural diplomacy, which, without aiming to remove the traditional diplomacy of dialogue between different interests and supported by different kind of pressures, as well as force threatening, can enrich it with a new element, dialogue based on understanding the other. And in a wider meaning, I talk about a better understanding of the world we live in. In my opinion, the first step of the cultural diplomacy should take would be to make conceptual map of the international political universe. On it, we could draw the different worlds populating our planet, the postmodern, the modern, and the pre-modern ones. Only on such a foundation we can build politics and security strategies proper for a fastly changing and contradictory world. The Russia-Georgia war in August 2008 acted like a triggering element towards new theoretical approaches. Its immediate consequences have shown the inherent weakness of the frozen conflict-solving systems managed by OSCE in South Ossetia and by United Nations in Abkhazia. Beyond all these have come out of obvious the EU institutional blockings concerning the foreign policy and the conflicts within NATO. Also, the conflict enlargement was blocked. A major institutional crisis has come out visible on international level. Its components proved it as a crisis of means, a crisis of international law principles, as well as a moral crisis. Revising the security strategies based on new approach models imposed as a necessity. Within the debates on the security assessment and planning's logics, two theoretical approaches have emerged. According to the first one, which is also the oldest, the world is unipolar due to USA's superpower, which have invested during the last 10 years double of the amount of the military budget of all the other states in scientific and technological research for military purposes. The world can be defined also as unipolar from the point of view of the Western liberal democracy model that assures economic development and prosperity. In my opinion, this is a void approach. Even the United States have avoided to proclaim themselves as a unique power. We talk not only about the public statement. I have attended President Clinton's many statements within closer or close meetings, and I can make a testimony about his concern in fighting and consulting his political and military partners during crisis moments like Yugoslavia crisis. The short authoritarian flare occurred as the beginning of President George Bush's the second term has been fastly sanctioned by the reality, and President Obama has relaunched an internationally consultation politics. The model of a unique type of democracy is also void. I had the chance to show at the Harvard University during a conference chaired by the late Professor Huntington. My cautions regarding his theory on the civilization clashing. According to this theory, Europe was divided into the Western civilization area based on the Catholic Protestant mentality, the only one capable to sustain a liberal democracy, and the Orthodox one enabled to promote democracy. The integration into the EU of Greece, Romania, and Bulgaria have come to contradict this theory, which will also be disarmed by the next integration into the EU of other Orthodox nations like Serbia and Macedonia, but also Muslim nations like Albania, Bosnia-Herzegovina, or Kosovo. At the International Conference in Seoul in 1994, I have come against the theory of inadequacy to the liberal democracy of the Asian nations. In this case, also the reality of building sustainable democratic system in countries with high economic development and life standards like Japan or South Korea deny this theory. The way toward the liberal democracy is open for many types of civilization. The second approach describes the world as unimultipolar with an anarchic periphery. Within this context, the USA can not act alone, but only together with other powers. The West itself is multipolar and irregular. This theoretical approach is closer to reality and is confirmed by the recent evolutions. The fact that, when facing the events in Kosovo and Georgia, the NATO and EU member countries shown different positions, just like regarding the military intervention in Iraq and Afghanistan, has proved that the Western multipolarity is a fact. It is generated by the very domestic democracy and by the one within the international institution and bodies it had created. The examples presented above still keep within the Westphalian concept, according to which only the states are subject of international law. On the future, the European and world security, as well as each state security, should adapt to the postmodern society. The state will probably remain for a long time for now, or not only the security object, subject, but also its guarantees. Meanwhile, we are also forced to take into account the fact that the postmodern world created solidarities of racial, ethnical, sexual groups that transcend the states. Thus, we should not see the state security only as a goal, but also as a way to assure the security for different groups and for citizens seen as persons with own interests and options. The world economic crisis led to a positive reassessment of the state role as protector of the citizens against abuses coming from those who assured the 20th century state progress and prosperity, transnational economic and financial company. A partnership between the private sector and the civil society promoting the corporate social responsibility may create the trust necessary to overcome present and future crises. In order to achieve all these things, we need a better understanding of the globalized world. It can be characterized as a risk society, to which a great number of citizens have already adapted. These global citizens, especially young people under 40 years, do not assume long-term identities and loyalties, but only pragmatic and present ones. They are very active and mobile and settle according to each person's character in areas offering them a minimum of risk or, on the contrary, a maximum of opportunity. This kind of population is expected to raise its number during the next years. This trend is accompanied by another one where groups or persons lead their life according to the former bipolar world in black and white, even though the religious or ethnical intolerances have replaced the ideological ones. They represent a potential anarchy group. Even if this trend display in a flat world, they are also relics of old societies separated through deep fissures from the postmodern or modern world. This is why the international community approach on every topic should take into account the perceptions of each actor involved. In our contemporary world, state can no longer be conventionally divided in blocks because the reactions following different interests lead to changing the alliances and the opposite part on different topics or subject. On one hand, it is a reflex of the contemporary world democratization, but also of the government's pragmatism forced to respond to the needs of their own citizens. Problems of transition toward democracy, along with the separatism and the delay in consolidating the new independent states, create on their terms risk directly connected to the state and government political legitimacy. The mafia type course nourishing separatism and blocking the new state consolidation put a question mark of the capability of fighting the institutionalized corruption. A threat associated to the democracy global model is a populism. Populism can lead to weakening the power and efficiency of the key democratic institution of the independence of justice, mass media, and army. The elements, along with the existing old frozen conflicts, aroused concern both about the dividing tendency within the new independent states, but also about the terrorist element transit to Europe, as well as about maintaining the backward mentalities, generating attractiveness towards authoritarian administrative models. Can we face such diverse challenges? With what kind of arguments? With what means? Conflict prevention and post-conflict situation management require a more comprehensive perspective that will allow the development of the global or regional institution complementarity. A balanced vision should take into account the interests of different ethnical and religious communities, the state obligation and their citizens' natural rights, the conjuncturous and long-term interests of regional actors. It cannot be elaborated without involving representatives competent to express the voice plurality, question and aspiration from billions of people. Political structures should be supplemented by civil society structures dedicated to world security issues. Only such a process to consolidate the respect for human, democracy, and common security may reach the depth that only people's real will can guarantee. The preventive vocation will constitute the keystone of its short-term activities. This fact involves the raising complexity of the analysis and action ways. The repetitive crises have shown that, unfortunately, punctual preventive intervention are not enough and should be inserted in the complex of long-term action, which needs to take into account the overall aspects of the some region and the overall aspects of the problem that might create, destabilize, starting with economic difficulties and going to the stereotypes anchored in conflictual mentalities from the communication ways, precariousness to the security and conventional risk. Cultural diplomacy can work as a laboratory where is created the global security political culture through mutual trust, negotiation, and cooperation. It can identify the major risk, can conceive and apply programs of mutual trust enhancement, both within countries with a high risk degree, but also within conflict potential regions. Within this laboratory, I believe that exists a privileged place for the former president and former prime minister in term during the transition from the communist dictatorship to the democratic state's status. Their civic and reformer political leaders' experience, their mutual relationship, and the prestige they have gained can play a role both in conflict diffusing, but also in reconceiving long-term strategies. The important contribution of the preventive cultural diplomacy to the security architecture in Europe and in the entire world will be, with no doubt, the one of war that would have not taken place due to creating a few democratic dialogue mechanisms and to strengthening of the collaboration with the civil society. Thank you for your attention.